Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Today I'm working on my sister's house in New Brighton, and it's kind of a difficult house, pretty unique, so we'll go ahead and take a look and see what's involved. This house was built in the 1970s, I believe, and we had a radon level of about four to five while I've been monitoring. It's a split entry with a tuck under garage, so it's pretty unique, and almost every one of these houses I've worked on has been a challenging one. So let's go ahead and take a look and see what's involved with some of it. So one of the big challenges is this house doesn't have drain tile. Here's some of the soil I've taken out of here. I've gotten rid of some of it already. But I think I've got 35 gallons on the suction point I dug last weekend. And I've got about 25 on the suction point that I'm about to show you today. So here's some of the dirt that's come out of there. And it's clay with some really fine sand, and it's got some moisture to it, so it's really hard to move air through that. So let's take a look in the house. So if you remember from some of our other videos we've done here, we've got the steps here, and we've got those couple of test holes. I'll show you that. So we've got that blue tubing there, and then there's another test hole under the stairs. And if you've seen our other video where we seal where that orange foam is. And then, forgive the mess, all the stuff from storage had to come out into the living area here. But the main thing I want to show you is that white cap over there in the floor. That's a plumbing clean out, so the plumber could snake out to the street if they wanted to. We'll go in the laundry room here because this is where all the action's happening. So if you've watched any of our other videos, you've heard me talk about houses without drain tile. We want to be next to settling. So we want to be next to the footing and next to plumbing if possible. So in this case, we've got plumbing on the back of the house here. But there's some sort of makeshift water drainage system they have here. So I'm kind of reluctant to seal this up because I don't want to flood her basement and I don't know exactly what they've got going on. So there, we've got a little air leak there, which I'm reluctant to seal. So if you've got leaks you can't seal, you want to get away from them. And then the garage floor, you may have noticed, is new. So they poured that before Callie bought the house last summer. So we've got no footing running through there. So we've got old slab versus new slab. A lot of times that's not airtight. And then for pressure field extension, so how far our suction point is reaching, the key to getting levels low typically is to get suction or vacuum on the entire home. We've got a center footing right here. This is a load bearing wall, which is blocking our airflow because the footing's about 20 inches wide and about 8 inches deep, sitting on clay. Our center footing ends here, and then it transfers to a beam, and then same in the garage. There's no center footing, it goes to a beam there as well. So right here is the suction point I worked on last weekend, and I've just had a temporary radon system running. So this is just a hole I cored through the floor. You can see there, that moisture is from the condensation of the draining back to the suction point. So with this suction point, I've just got this flex duct hooked up and running out the window to a radon fan in the backyard. This did not achieve negative pressure under the entire house. We're just barely reach in some areas, and we're still positive in the under the stairs there in that blue test hole. This dropped our radon levels from, let me see, by the bed there we were 1.4, by the desk we were 2.6, under the stairs we were 0.9, and here in the laundry room on top of the fridge we were 1.6. So we got some reduction, but we can do better than that. So I racked my brain, how can we get next to plumbing? I dug all the way over to here and dug to about here. Didn't find the plumbing, talked to a plumber. He's like, yeah, they gotta be there. You know, they wouldn't have run under the footing. Well, I did some research. I pulled the trigger, got a micro reel. So this is a sewer camera. The cool thing about it is it's got a transmitter in the head here. So I put that down the plumbing, down a clean out for the floor drain, and I was able to trace exactly where it runs. And this, so this is in the sewer pipe below the slab, and this helps me locate and find out where it is. It also tells me how deep it is. So no more guessing. So the plumbing ran actually right under the fridge, right where this blue masking tape is. It did go under the footing, and it ran out to that clean out we looked at earlier. So I added a suction point here where this duct tape is. There was some settling under the footing, found that plumbing, actually found the water main where it comes into the house as well, the 1-inch copper line. So it's helpful for that as well. But I dug a 20 to 25 gallon pit here, and then I dug over and tied into my original suction point. So from here, I'm going to run pipe up. I think I'm gonna try to, I'll go up in the attic next and confirm that this route works. But I'm gonna try to come up over here and run up next to the chase, next to the B vent for the water heater. So that's what I'm gonna go do next and make sure that this route works. Otherwise it's back to the drawing board and try to find a closet or a wall that we can run up through. And then just to show you, I'll shut that radon fan off now. Just to show you the suction point, in case you're curious to what they look like. I don't know how much you'll be able to see, but here we've got the footing. So the slab's only, you know, 2.5-3 inches thick here. And then I'm kind of blowing it out with the light, but right here is the footing, and then you might be able to see if I can get this in there. You can see that plumbing when I get my big arm out of the way. That cast iron plumbing is actually, yep, right through there. And then the water line is on the other side of it. I don't think you'll be able to see that though, I could just feel it. So we went from 4.9 inches of suction with that radon fan, moving about 1 CFM, so hardly any air, to down to 4.3 inches. So that's how much suction the radon fan is applying to the soil. And we're probably moving, I haven't measured, but probably between 20 and 30 CFM with this current setup. You see when I shut the radon fan off, the numbers are both positive. I'll put this duct tape cover back on there and we'll turn that fan back on and show you what happens when we turn that on. So you'll see those numbers start to go down. I just turned the phone on, or the radon fan. And this is gonna be the one that's hard to reach. And there's a lot of settling in that area too. It's kind of tied to the garage. So worst case scenario, I'm going to put a T in the pipe with a cap on it, and we'll be able to run a pipe over the hallway closet, or sorry, over the hallway here. So we'll run a pipe over a 2-inch pipe likely, and then down and trap a suction point in there. But I'm really hoping we don't have to do that because it's a lot of work. So I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more on this house because it's a problem child. One other thing to mention, we covered another video about 6 months ago, but under the furnace, well, you're not going to be able to see it here, but under the furnace there was a big hole. They had probably the temporary or the original furnace installed in the house. They probably built it in the winter, so the concrete guys couldn't get concrete under the furnace, so we had a big, you know, about 1 foot by 1 foot hole. We've got another video that we talk about it. So again, I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more on this problem house.